Hello, Ghani, and welcome to this very exciting edition of Black Theater Today. I'm your host, Tiffany Pettis, and thank you for tuning in to the best in African-American theater, both locally and nationally. Now, speaking of local African-American theater, we're right here at the Center for the Dance Arts in Little Rock, Arkansas. A little later in the show, we'll be talking with the founder and main choreographer, C. Michael Tidwell, and a few of his dancers. So as the lights fade and the curtains open, take your seat for the best in African-American dance with the Tidwell Project Dance Ensemble right here on Black Theater Today. Legendary choreographer and dance instructor Alvin Ailey used the art of dance to mold the lives of African-American youths in New York. He instilled in them a burning desire to succeed and realize their full potentials not only in dance, but in life as well. Alvin Ailey's legacy can be experienced a little closer to home, thanks to one of his students, C. Michael Tidwell, who for the past 20 years has been devoted to encouraging discipline, both in the minds and bodies of students, while sharing the gift of dance.
If it's in them to dance, or to play the piano, or to sing, regardless of what your plans are, that's what they're going to do, that's what they have to do. So as a teacher and a dancer, it's something I had to do. I didn't know anything else. So, you know, I breathe it, I live it, and want to share it and pass it on to my students.
This, in turn, encourages true feelings of self-assurance and self-esteem. Tidwell, himself a professional dancer and noted choreographer, residency at Valley, Arkansas, but he realized a special need for talented dancers like himself. This need led to the development of the Center for the Dance Arts, which is located right here in Little Rock.
As an African American, I've always danced, been a part of culture always. That's always been a part of my culture. But when I went to college or started dancing what I call an artistic dance, very few black kids in there. I was dancing with Valley, Arkansas, there were maybe four of us. And when I say us, I'm talking about African Americans, not in the company, just in the full school and the whole production. And I thought, there must be something I can do to make this a bit more inclusive. So the Tidwell Project was basically formed for the community, really, for those kids. You know, everyone is not going to be a classical ballet dancer, though ballet is taught here. I believe it is a foundation for dance. But there are other aspects. There's jazz, there's ethnic dance that is rich in our lives. And so what I try to do is incorporate all of that, the ballet, the jazz, ethnic, and it makes a more well-rounded dance curriculum, and that's what I teach here. These kids have a good time with it. They all find something they can relate to, so that's how we started.
It is through the center's extensive dance curriculum of pliés, pirouettes, and brushes that students learn to build character and an appreciation for hard work and the arts in general.
Mr. Tidwell is a really good instructor, and I learn a lot from him other than just dancing. I learn a lot of things about life.
And I've always believed that dance is a foundation with that dedication and discipline, that if they can master this, they can take this into anything they decide to do in life, and will work out fine for them, I believe. One thing I say to them is, don't give up. If it's in you to dance, no matter what choreographer or what director tells you you're not his type, remember that's a personal choice. He may like all 5'8" dancers, and you may be 5'1". But one day along the way, you're going to run to a choreographer who likes 5'1 dancers, and you have to be ready. So when the door opens, you step right in.
Black Theater Today salutes C. Michael Tidwell for his creative contributions to the cultural, artistic, and aesthetic needs of the African-American community, and most of all, for inspiring us through the gift of dance. The Tidwell Project Dance Ensemble is the dance company of the Center for the Dance Arts. The ensemble has received state and nationwide recognition.
This idea came to me probably 10 years ago, but it's taken a long time. It's always been a dream of mine, but it's taken a while to get this into being. This is the third year of the company. We perform just as a group around the city. We've been in the Black Hall of Fame, Martin Luther King Celebration, and several things we've been invited to do. And finally, when I opened the school, I had a place for them to rehearse, had a place for them to come and take class, and from that, the company expanded from the school.
The company is comprised of 15 dancers, male and female, from different walks of life. Some students with majors ranging from pre-law to broadcasting. And although being a member of the company is hard work, with rigorous rehearsals 3 times a week and public performances year-round, the dancers, in return, find that their hard work always pays off.
It helps me with just to focus on everything that I do in my life, or as just to be dedicated. Being a dancer is a lot of hard work, and you have to be dedicated and work really hard, and I apply that to everything that I do.
Dance has been traditionally dominated by females, but as one student informed us, it can be a man's world too.
A lot of people don't expect you to dance because you're a guy. They think it's feminine. However, they don't realize that's where most of the girls are. And it's just real recreational and gives you a lot of exercise, keeps me in shape, mm-hmm. and it's just a lot of fun.
The company's seeds of hard work reap a bountiful crop of polished dancers, phenomenal performances, and standing ovations. And speaking of standing ovations, in June, the summer heats up even more when the Ensemble performs for the Center for the Dance Arts' electrifying annual showcase. And if you missed June's show, no doubt you missed a treat. But don't worry, you'll get to experience the magic right here on Black Theater Today.
We're gonna do this.